All right, so let's kick things off here by talking about the most basic entry point of all, which is the Facebook page. All this means is a user is landing on your Facebook page and then they're sending you a message. Now, this can actually take some other forms as well that are just technically worth mentioning, but more often than not, this entry point just means a user is coming to your page and clicking that big blue send message button. But again, some corner case examples are if somebody searches for your page on Messenger and they message you there, or if they come in through a direct m.me link, meaning there are no ref links attached to that. But again, that gets kind of technical. Don't worry about it. Basically, a user sends you a message when they're on your Facebook page. So let's take a look and show you what this looks like a little bit more in depth. So here we are on my Facebook page, this fictitious furniture brand that I've created, and you see the big blue send message button. So I'll click on that and you'll see what it looks like, this Facebook page entry point. So here, there are really two things worth noting. At the very bottom here, you see the get started button. And that's of course the classic way to initiate a chatbot conversation. Somebody clicks on that and it takes them to the welcome message that we have set up. Alternatively, or in addition, you have these three questions here, these frequently asked questions, which are called icebreakers. And this is a new feature that we support, which is awesome. Basically, if a user has a frequently asked question, they just want to get a very quick response, they click that and you can provide that immediate instantaneous answer. So the next question is, well, how do you set all this up in Chatfuel? So let me switch tabs here and show you in Flow Builder. So here I've already created a very basic, you know, welcome message here for this furniture brand. And I'm trying to be a little bit clever and funny by calling the persona for this bot Fern Itcher, like that's its name. So yeah, I know I'm clearly a comedian. Don't worry, mom and dad, I'm not gonna quit my day job. Anyway, so the question is, how do you set up this entry point now that you have this welcome message? All you do, super simple, you double click anywhere on the canvas and add the Facebook page entry point. I'll drag this over here, move this up, and then simply connect the get started quick reply to that block, right? And we're done. All we need to do now is just toggle this switch right here to set it live, and we're good to go. But of course, as promised, there is one other important thing to mention here. Optionally, if we want to, we can add those icebreakers. So there are two ways to do this. You can either add them manually, you know, type out whatever question you anticipate the user might ask and then type out the response, or a magical thing we have set up here is fill with data from Facebook page. So if you click that, it will populate all of these frequently asked questions automatically and then give you a template for the response. So these are basic things like, how do I contact you? What are your business hours, phone number, email, things like that. And it's all done for you. Now, if you want to customize some of these data fields, if for whatever reason they are missing from your Facebook page, like your phone number or your website, you can do that in the Configure tab under Global Attributes, but that's more technical. Not going to cover that right now. Just know that you can edit them if you so choose. So that's really all there is. Again, we've set up the get started button to that welcome message. We've added the optional icebreakers. And then again, all there is left to do is just toggle this switch to set this live on our Facebook page so that entry point is active. So I'll do that right now. It's gonna give me a warning message, which is fine. It's just gonna say basically, hey, you have only one Facebook page entry point that you can use in your entire bot. So if you enable this entry point, if you're using, you know, the Facebook page entry point elsewhere in your bot, that is gonna, you know, be paused and this current entry point is gonna override it. And again, that makes sense. Users are only getting one Facebook page welcome message, if you will, one entry point per bot. So you can just click continue here. And you're all set. Now users will be able to quickly ask and get answers to those questions and go through the rest of your bot flow. So that is the Facebook page entry point. Try it today.